over him was brokenness and strife, but he made something beautiful of my life.
Well then, my friends, dear friends and family, today I'd like to speak to you about the face in the mirror. I wonder, when you look into the mirror, what do you see? And how do you feel about what you see? You say sometimes we allow people to define us and form opinions about us. And then we adapt and change who we are in order to get a better definition and opinion from others. And the question is, why do we do that? It makes us feel good. You see, young men and women, even children, sell their bodies and give themselves to others in search for that good feeling. And then they end up all messed up. But I want to tell you today that God knew you and had a destiny for you before people could even criticize you or speak out an opinion about you. Psalm 139 verse 15 says, "You know me inside and out. You know every bone in my body. You know exactly how I was made bit by bit. How I was sculpted from nothing into something." You see, my friend, God who sculpted you, who formed you in your mother's womb, is the only one whose opinion counts. He's the only one that saw you valuable enough to give his life for you, to redeem you from the slavery of sin. Listen, Romans 3:23 says, "For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God." I don't want to take out sinners this morning because all of us, says the word, have sinned. But all of us is in need of a Savior and who loves us, who want to care for us, and who better as the one who has formed you in your mother's womb. Who better as the one who has a destiny for you. Who better as the one who has already given his life for you, Jesus Christ. The one who says in Isaiah 43 verse 1, "Fear not, I have redeemed you, I have called you by your name. You are mine." You see, with God, you do not have to pretend. You do not have to change. When you're in a relationship with him, he will transform you. He is the master potter, and he never throws away the clay. You see, people has a tendency to throw you away the moment they can't gain anything from you. The moment they have no use for you, because they never paid a price for you. But you are God's beloved before you were born. He sculpted you from nothing to something. He has called you by your name. You are his. You may say or think that you have failed him so many times. You've done the worst. He can't forgive you. Let me encourage you. God is a God of second chances. He forgives more than 70 times, 7 times any given day. The world and the devil will never, ever give you a second chance. They would rather bury you alive because you're not good enough according to their standards. But praise God, he knows our worth. You and I were worthy enough for him to lay down his life. I want to tell every teenager, every young adult, every mother and father out there, you can and never will find fulfillment in the opinion of others except God's. He's the only one worthy of our opinion. You see, fulfillment is found in living God's dream for your life. He has a destiny for you. He has a future for you. You are skillfully, wonderfully made. The one who knows your name has called you even before conception. Listen, dear friend, give God control over your life. Let Him make something beautiful of your life. Like the song says, something beautiful, something good. All my confusions He understood. All I had to offer Him was suffering and pain, but He gave something beautiful. He made something beautiful of my life. The world and the devil will tell you you are beautiful. But after they've messed up your beauty, they will spit you out and throw you to the dogs as a good for nothing. But I want to encourage you from God's word with two last verses from the Message version of the Bible in Zephaniah 3:17. It says, your God is present among you, a strong warrior there to save you, happy to have you back. He will calm you with His love and delight you with His songs. Wow! Listen to this. He delight you with His songs. He sings over you. The God who created the universe is excited about you. He delights Himself in you. Almost like two young lovers singing songs and writing poems to each other. You excite God. He loves you. He cares for you. Jeremiah 31 verse 3 says, I've never quit loving you and I never will. Expect love, love, and more love. Wow. What a privilege to have a God like Jehovah who cares for us, who wants to have a relationship with us, who's in love with us. Shall we pray? Father God, I know this morning, today there are someone out there who's feeling desperate, who needs love, who feels like a no good for nothing. I know there are someone out there who sits with depression and says, is my life worth it all? Definitely yes, because you love each and all. Definitely yes, therefore by your Spirit, let your word today penetrate into every heart, every body and soul. To know for sure, Father God, that they're worth something, that you love them, you've given your life for them, and you want to care for them. May you keep and bless each and every one. In Jesus' wonderful name. Amen. Please, my dear friend, remember one thing. You can forget everything I've told you, I've said today. Remember one thing, God's love never fails. And only He can make something beautiful, something good, out of something not so good. May God bless you till we meet again. Amen.
But He made something.